Canadians are voting to choose their next leader, and what a nail biter of an election it's been so far. It's a battle for survival for Canada's Prime Minister Justin Trudeau, who is fighting to remain in power, and he has used every trick up his sleeve because these are desperate times, and hence the desperate measures. What's more telling then, Trudeau has also admitted that his rival could win the elections.
The choice is clear, my friends, in this election. We need to get out over the rest of today, be super active tomorrow with our neighbors, with our friends, as volunteers, right across the Lower Mainland, right across British Columbia, right across the country, as Canadians come together to choose forward. Merci tout le monde. Merci.
So is Trudeau's rival Andrew Scheer the favorite? Again, not easy to tell here. This looks like a cliffhanger. But one thing is for sure, the Conservative leader has come out all guns blazing. Yesterday, he even raised alarms of a tax raise if Trudeau returned to power.
Thanks very much, everyone. Merci beaucoup. These coalition deficits will raise your taxes and starve our vital public services of much needed funds.
And then there is the presence of Jagmeet Singh, the leader of the New Democratic Party, set to complicate the results. Jagmeet will surely not be a contender for the top job, but he could be the kingmaker in the event of a fractured mandate. By the way, Jagmeet Singh is the first man of Indian origin to lead a major political party in Canada. So how did the campaign trail go? Who has the momentum? These are interesting questions. Trudeau had a terrible time ahead of the elections. The blackface images and charges of racism surely had an impact given Canada's multiculturalism. His reputation on climate action has also suffered a major dent. Here is a leader who bats for climate change but endorsed the Trans Mountain Pipeline expansion. This project would triple the capacity to carry nearly 9 lakh barrels of crude oil from Alberta to British Columbia's Pacific coast. Another irony is this, that Canada has not fulfilled the commitments when it comes to the Paris Climate Agreement on climate action. Meanwhile, the Conservative Party and Andrew Scheer have promised reforms and jobs. Andrew Scheer has also appeased his core vote bank by firmly positioning against same-sex marriage and abortion. Let's take a look now at some of the opinion polls to get a better sense of that neck-and-neck battle. Conservatives are expected to bag 32.5% vote share, while Justin Trudeau's Liberal Party is pegged to garner 31.9% vote share. That's too close, not even a percentage of a difference. And here's where the New Democratic Party comes to prominence, like we just said. Jagmeet Singh is expected to get little less than 19% vote share. Exactly how will this translate to seats is a different issue altogether, of course. Trudeau's party got absolute majority in 2015 in the 338-seat House of Commons. This time, such a majority looks impossible. But it will be wrong to write off Justin Trudeau altogether because he has an inherent advantage here. In case of fractured mandate, Trudeau will get the first chance to form a government. According to Canada's laws, besides the possibility of Jagmeet Singh supporting Trudeau is more than the possibility of him siding with Conservative Party. Besides, people of Indian origin could decide the leader's fate. Last time around, they supported Trudeau, but now thanks to Trudeau's blackface controversy and pro-Khalistan stance, he could lose the vote back. Jagmeet Singh may not benefit from this, because he too has pro-Khalistan sentiments. So when can we expect the results then and more clarity? After polling ends, the votes will be counted immediately by the election commission officials. So expect results to trickle in as soon as the polls get over the next few hours. Preliminary results will be put up on the official website of the Canadian Election Commission. But there's a catch here. If the vote is very close to call, then the ballots may be recounted under the supervision of a judge. In a few hours from now, we will know which way Canada has swayed this time. Let's also tell you the story that's also dominating headlines from Canada. And this does not concern any political leader, but a voter. 18-year-old Madison Yetman, bedridden and diagnosed with terminal cancer, came to vote. She also put out a video message. Few weeks to live, and yet the elections meant a lot. clearly there is a lot riding on these elections for the parties, the leaders and the public. This is the message that she sent out, appealing the voters should come out and exercise their franchise.
If I can find the time to vote, you can find the time to vote.